Good afternoon, everybody. Thank you for your patience. We have Rasheed Walker here. His camera's not working, just an FYI, but he is here. But we'll go same as always. If you use the raise your hand, we'll come over and ask you or unmute you so you can ask a question. We'll start with Rich Scarsella.
Good afternoon, Rasheed. How are you?
Good afternoon. I'm doing good. How are you?
I'm good. Rasheed, how frustrating is it for you to see the running game not be more productive than it's been?
It's not about frustration. It's just about, like, you know, just everything, you know, it's just a process. You know, we just, you know, sometimes things don't always want to go exactly as planned, exactly how we want them to go. But, like, it's not about getting frustrated. It's just about keep on trying and keep on just trying to prepare better and just learn from, you know, what has occurred already to just, you know, just keep building that foundation and get things going. So it's not really about frustration.
Tyler Donahue.
Yeah, hi, Rasheed. I hope you're doing well. Now that you're through 8 games here, how do you evaluate the way you have performed individually? And do you feel like you validated a lot of the work you put in during the offseason that you've told us about?
I think I played pretty well. Like, I mean, obviously you always have those, you know, plays that you wish you can get back. But, you know, I think my work that I put in the offseason has showed. And as far as, like, the rest of my guys, I think everybody, we're still, like, stacking days. Everyone has improved since last season. And yeah.
Kyle Andrews.
Hey, Rasheed. I hope everything's going well. Being from Maryland, and, you know, growing up in Waldorf and playing football there, as well as being recruited by the Terps too, you know, how important is it to be able to go back home to the state and you know, play as well as you possibly can? And then, I mean, also, how much did you, you know, how familiar were you with the Maryland football program growing up as well?
I was recruited heavily by Maryland and Tyler Bone was there. And, you know, I also know, like, had a lot of good relationships with a lot of players and coaches there. So it's always cool, you know, just to, you know, share the field with those guys, you know, the one time we get to share it for a year. And it'll also be cool to be able to just smell the Maryland air, because it is different. But, you know, it's just going to be a good feeling to just be back home playing. And especially knowing that, like, a lot of my family members will be able to be at the game because of how, like, close it is to them, because I'm from Maryland. So, I mean, it's going to be real fun. It's going to be a good feeling.
Seth Engel.
Hey, Rasheed. So you've obviously been a teammate of Sean Clifford's for a few years now. So, you know, what does it say about your trust in him that he's able to throw the ball over 50 times against a team like Ohio State on Saturday?
My trust in him?
Yeah.
You're saying like, hold on, can you repeat that question again?
Yeah, so Sean threw the ball more than he has all season on Saturday, and this is coming off an injury. So can you just speak about your trust in him to be able to throw the ball as much as he did, you know, with everything going on this season?
Like I said previously, like, Sean, he's, like, grown, like tremendously as a quarterback this past season. So, like, you know, I always trust him to, like, you know, to, like, make a pass, like, you know, like, half the time where, you know, he throws the ball, even if he doesn't, like, complete the pass or the pass is completed, like, I'm still going to do my job, like, so my job is just to, like, block and just let him do him. That's me. So I feel like that trust is just a must for what we're trying to do on offense.
Joe Smeltzer.
So what would you say your impressions are of Maryland defensively, particularly up front?
They're really, like, sound, physical, front, you know, they're pretty good. They have good players, and they just, you know, is a good football team and just, like, as a whole.
Tyler Donahue?
Rasheed, we've heard a couple times in the last week that Olufoshinu has put himself in a position to, you know, make an impact for this team if he needed to. Where has he come along at tackle, and, you know, ultimately at your position potentially, where do you think he can go?
Olu, he's a guy. He's also from Baltimore, Maryland, and like, he's done a great job this offseason. Like, probably one of the biggest 18-year-olds I've ever met in my life. You know, he's very smart, very coachable, and has all the tools to be a great offensive lineman. So I think, like, you know, as hard as he works, like, he's ready, like, to fit those shoes when the time is needed. So, yeah, his progress since he's been here has been great.
Joe Giuliano?
Hi, Rasheed. I wondered, through eight games, if there's a common theme behind the run game struggles. Is it, you know, guys missing a block, or one guy not doing his job, or the running back missing a hole? What can you put your finger on? Anything?
Nah, I really can't.
John Petitschnock?
Hey, Rasheed. When you guys are traveling, you know, whether it's by plane or bus, you know, are you a guy who likes to talk? Are you a guy who likes to just kind of stay quiet and focused in 24 hours leading up to kickoff? What are your emotions like? Is it something that you build up to kickoff, or just wanted to get your thoughts on that? Thank you.
Thank you. That's actually a great question. So usually like 24 hours before the game is just like, how far you want me to go back for my preparation?
Just 24 hours. Yeah. I mean,
yeah, that 24 hours, like, usually we, you know, wake up. If it's a away game, we practice in the morning. If it's a home, we practice in the evening. But, you know, wake up, do what I have to do before practice. Then we have a jog through practice, and we just like run a few plays, make sure we're sharp. And then from there, we go to the team hotel where we go over our, like, test and tip sheets with, like, our position groups. And we get those tests and tip sheets, like, a little bit earlier in the week to work on, like, basically, you know, ask questions like, who are you going to be going up against? What are the tendencies? What are the affirmations? What do they like to do? We go over that. We do more walkthroughs. And typically, like, you know, I wouldn't say I'm very uptight, but I just be chilling, like, you know, I'm focused. I'm not doing too much. I'm just staying calm. And you know, the night before, I'll usually, you know, go over my test again before I go to sleep. And then the day of game day, that's when I just wake up and I'm just, you know, I'm tuned in.
Rich Scarsella.
Rasheed, where have you seen the greatest growth on the offensive line since training camp?
Just the toughness of our group, like, you know, regardless of, like, what the outcome of any game has been, I feel like me and my guys play our tails off, like, from the first snap to the last snap. And, you know, that's actually kind of hard to do, you know, when, you know, as an offensive line, where we're in, especially when we're, like, sometimes we're in very tough situations, it's hard to, you know, keep straining like that. And I feel like we've just been doing a great job with straining and just leaving everything out on the field.
Daniel Galen.
Hey, Rasheed. On the other side of the ball, guys like Keziah Izzard and Devon Ellis have had the opportunity to step up into bigger roles. From your perspective as an offensive lineman, how have you kind of seen those guys come along, you know, in the offseason and when they're on scout team earlier in their careers?
You know, it's always good to see, because, like, you know, us all being on the team together, you know, some guys play more than others, but we all work. Everyone works hard. Like, it shouldn't be a time where someone's working harder than next. We're all, you know, getting a fair share of the same amount of reps. So it's just, you know, and I, like, everybody's, like, you know, mindset should be just, like, you never know when your time has come, so you always got to be prepared. So it's always just, like, I always have, like, a proud moment, you know, when I see Keziah, like, how he's, like, go from being on scout team to making plays in Beaver Stadium. Like, And same with Divine. And it's like, you know, me being an older guy, I remember when they first got to college and, you know, the the difficulties that they had and how they struggled making the transition. And now they're actually on the field, you know, making plays. So, yeah, I'm just really proud of everyone who's been able to step up and help the team.
All right, we got time for the last two. We'll go Seth and then Tyler.
So historically speaking, you know, Penn State is 40-3 against this Maryland team. You know, why do you believe that that program at Maryland still believes that Penn State is, you know, one of their biggest rivals?
Well, probably a number of reasons. You know, I know when I was getting recruited, their main, you know, thing they were saying was they need all the Maryland guys to stay home. And, you know, Penn State has a history of, you know, taking a bunch of, it's like a pipeline from Maryland to Penn State. So, I mean, that probably has something to do with it. Just a bunch of mob ties and, you know, we're probably the closest. That's Maryland's probably the closest school to Penn State other than, like, when we used to play Pitt or whatever. So, it's always going to be some type of conversation when you have two different teams that are so close to each other. Like,
and Tyler, go ahead and finish us off.
Thank you. Rasheed, we just heard from James Franklin about Christian and what he's done at quarterback, over the course of the season, improving, progressing. What have you seen from Christian as a freshman? We haven't had a long look at him from the outside looking in.
Oh, well, CV, he's like a very bright kid, like very funny, always has energy. And, from what I've seen from him in practice, like, one, he's talented. He's, like, has the tools to be a great quarterback. But he's also, like, not scared to get his hands dirty. Like, there'll be times in practice where they'll be, like, having, like, you know, the freshman scrimmage, and then he'll make a pass and then go downfield and block somebody. Like, so just things like that that he does, is that those things are kind of impressive.
Great. Thank you, everybody, for your time this afternoon. And thank you, Rasheed, for your time as well.
All right. Thanks, Nicole. Thanks, Rasheed.